So today I'm gonna answer the most common question I get from you guys, which is I have this and that camera, I am looking to buy my first macro lens, what macro lens do you recommend? So in this video I'm gonna answer it once and for all. I'm gonna go through all the major camera systems and give you my recommendations on good beginner macro lenses. So without further ado, let's go! First of all, I just want to make one thing clear though. Macro lenses, they are pretty simple. It's pretty hard to mess it up when you're making a macro lens. So no matter what macro lens you buy, you will probably get a good one. You would have to be pretty unlucky to get a bad macro lens. Almost none of the macro lenses on the market have problems with chromatic aberrations or that they are not sharp or that they have distortion or anything. Most of them are really good. So if you would just like close your eyes and pick one at random, you would probably end up with a pretty good macro lens anyway. So let's talk about the different systems. First of all, let's start with the smallest sensor, Micro Four Thirds. So if you have an Olympus or a Panasonic camera with a Micro Four Thirds sensor, there is an array of available macro lenses. But to me, there is one that stands out as better than the rest, and that is the Olympus 60mm f2.8 macro lens. What is unique about this one is that it has the longest focal length of all the macro lenses for Micro Four Thirds. And that makes the background more compressed so that the bokeh looks a bit nicer, and also it gives you a better working distance. With macro lenses in general, the longer the focal length, the further away you can be from an insect or whatever you're photographing and still get it at full magnification. By the way, most of the macro lenses I'm gonna talk about in this video, they have one-time magnification or one-to-one magnification, which basically means that whatever you're photographing at the closest possible distance will be as big on the sensor as it is in real life. So if you have a very small sensor like Micro Four Thirds, you can shoot very small insects and they will still take up the whole sensor. The Micro Four Thirds sensor, I think it is 12 millimeters high. So basically, if you photograph something that is just 1.2 centimeters high, it will cover bottom to top of your image, which is pretty good. On a full frame sensor, one-to-one magnification will cover something that is 36 by 24 millimeter. Anyways, that's my recommendation for Micro Four Thirds. There are a lot of other macro lenses, but the Olympus 60mm is the one I would get. It isn't very expensive either, not much more expensive than any other of the others, and it's worth spending money on this lens. I actually made a complete video about that lens, so check that out. Here. Anyways, let's move on. APS-C. If you have a Canon DSLR with an APS-C sensor, basically all the models that have 2, 3, or 4 digits in the model number, like D70 or D7000, they have APS-C sensors. For these sensors, there are two lenses that I would recommend as beginner macro lenses. The first one is the Canon 60mm f2.8, which is made for APS-C cameras. That's a great macro lens. And the second one is a very similar lens, but made by a different brand, and that is the Tamron 60mm f2.8. Both of these lenses are great purchases, and buy whichever one you feel like buying or get a good price on, because they are both good choices. And why don't I recommend full frame lenses for your APS-C camera, you might ask. And that is basically my philosophy, that you should buy lenses made for your specific camera. I think that's in general a very good idea. If you have an APS-C camera and buy full frame lenses for it, sure, you can do that. I mean, it might be a great idea if you also have a full frame camera, or if you're planning to buy one very soon, that could be a good choice. But otherwise, you will just carry around extra weight for no purpose. I mean, the image circle will be much bigger than required, and you will carry more weight and have a bigger lens than you would need to, and probably pay more as well. So buy lenses made for the camera that you have. That's my recommendation. Moving on, if you have a Nikon DSLR with an APS-C sensor, I think this is called DX, or lenses made for DX, whatever. I never had an Nikon camera, so I'm not really sure. Then I would also recommend the Tamron 60mm f2.8, which I recommended for Canon. This lens also exists for Nikon, and it is just as good on Nikon cameras as on Canon cameras. So what about full frame? There are a lot... No, wait a minute, I forgot Fujifilm. So what about Fujifilm? Which is also APS-C, if you're not buying the medium format ones. For Fujifilm, they have two macro lenses in their lineup that is made by Fujifilm. The first one is the 60mm f2.4, which is a great all-round lens and a pretty good macro lens, but it only goes to 0.5 times magnification. So that's one thing to consider. If you're planning to photograph insects, it might not be the best macro lens. If you want one time magnification, go look at the Fujifilm 80mm macro lens. It is very expensive but superb optically. If you're budget minded and want a great macro lens for your Fujifilm camera, maybe you should buy the Samyang or Rokinon, which is also the same brand as Samyang but different name in the US for some reason. The 100mm Samyang f2.8 macro lens is a great macro lens. It's made for full frame, but it of course works great on a Fujifilm camera. So if you want something a little bit cheaper, maybe go for that one if you have Fujifilm. So what about full frame? There are a lot of options, of course, and I would say for a beginner, any telephoto macro lens made by the major brands, which is 90, 100 or 105mm in focal length, are great beginner options for macro lenses. All of them are optically good because, as I said earlier, it's pretty hard to mess up a macro lens. It's pretty hard to make a bad one. So buy a 90, 100 or 105mm macro lens from Nikon, Canon, Sony, Sigma, Tamron, Tokina, or Samyang / Rokinon. All of them are great lenses. They cost around the same. Some of them are a bit more expensive, but all of them are great lenses and you cannot go wrong with any of these. The difference is that some of them might have better or worse build quality, and some of them have built-in image stabilization and some of them do not. For example, the Samyang does not have that. And image stabilization might be a good thing if you're a beginner. It certainly makes it easier to like frame your shot because it gets very, very shaky at full magnification. Other than that, some of them have autofocus and the Samyang does not have autofocus. But for actual macro photography, autofocus is not something you would want to try to use anyway. It's really, really kind of impossible to make it work well. So be prepared to use manual focus anyway. I mean, you will mostly be focusing by moving back and forth and not by using the focus on the lens anyway. So these are my macro lens recommendations for you guys. If you're a beginner, any of these lenses that I've mentioned in this video is a great place to start. There are of course a lot of more macro lenses that are more advanced or rather harder to use, which I would recommend as a second or third macro lens. And I will get back to these in other videos. But if you're a beginner, I would just go for a regular telephoto macro lens with 1:1 magnification. That's a safe bet. It's a good purchase and it's easy to sell it further if you would not like macro photography. It's quite easy to get to sell them used because there is quite high demand for these lenses. So, that's it for the actual content of the video. In case you're curious about the future of this channel, I just wanted to make a little announcement here. I am super duper excited today because this is the first day ever that I'm actually, when I actually have a full day to do YouTube videos, to create YouTube videos for this channel. Before this, I had to like really scramble, find 1 hour there, 30 minutes there every day to like try to find time to make these videos. And still I managed to make quite a few videos, but it has been a struggle to find the time for it. And from now on, I have managed to get 2 whole days, at least every week, to work on my YouTube videos, which is so much fun. I'm really looking forward to spending more time making these videos and doing photography, doing more photography experiments, doing more macro photography now that the spring is coming. Oh my god, I look so much forward to it. And I hope this will result in more videos for you guys and better quality videos for you guys. So let's hope that I can keep up this thing where I work 2 whole days per week on my YouTube videos. Yeah, it's gonna be so much fun. If you did like this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up, which really helps this channel. And don't forget to subscribe. See you very soon again. Over and out. Bye.